Back with another reaction video here at Peerless Reactions, and we are back on the NF train. Better late than never, who cares? I don't know why I haven't done an NF track in such a long time, cause there's not many left to do, cause I'm almost on number 50 YouTube. Hey. This song is Notepad by popular demand. I love it when Nate gets deep and gets introspective. So stoked to get into this song, Notepad, off the Mansion album. Let's go.
You and I, we've been doing a lot together.
Now look. Who? Who's you and I?
Back, and I just, I appreciate all the times that we had together. You know, I remember just going down in my room and, you know, trying to deal with some things. And you've always been there for that. Always. It's me and you.
You and I been best friends ever since I was a young kid. Everything we did, where's time went? Got a lot of years coming up ahead of us, and ever since we met, I knew we'd get somewhere. But the fact is, I ain't really know when. I don't really know how either, but I can feel the goosebumps. My skin writes in.
This beat is fire already, and I love how aggressive he's coming out of this. I thought this was going to be kind of laid back and subtle, but he's coming out hard here. And I love when he talks about goosebumps all of a sudden, because in my last few reactions, my man has been giving me goosebumps. What's good?
I ain't really know when, I don't really know how either, but I can feel the goosebumps. My skin writes in, I've been waiting for the moment. You and I can make it happen. A lot of people thinking we ain't going to make it rap, and I ain't got a problem with them though. That don't even matter, we ain't looking for the people trying to say that we the baddest. Nah, never liked that. Came a long way, never did it for the money. We ever make it big, I'ma give it to the family. Looking back now, everything is looking funny. You and I in the room.
You know what? I love this when he's coming out here saying, look, I ain't doing this for the money. This ain't what it's about. I'm doing this for the fam. Doing this because I'm supposed to be doing it. Doing this because this is therapy for me.
Up late when the mood strikes us. We don't care if they do like us. Writing songs for the haters we ain't even got yet. Freestyling, somebody turn the mic up. Talking about things we don't really understand. Talking about things we don't really comprehend. Me and you trying to get it, we ain't quitting to the end. Now I'm standing on stage trying to give it to the fans. Yeah.
We took that karaoke machine from our room, and we put it up to the CD player and played the instrumentals, and man, we've come a long way. A long way.
I made a lot of mistakes. You've been there for the whole thing. Help me with the drama. Rapping in the car outside daily. We don't care if it's a winter, we don't care if it's a summer. I remember writing raps with the curse words. I just wanna hear, it seems like everybody does it. Did it for a while, wasn't into all the custom. Tried to find who I was, being everything I was in real life.
You know what, that's real right there, because, and no pun intended, because this is real music, but what gets me is that him being, he's so transparent, so honest, he's so just forthright with the things that he struggled with, to the point where he said, man, I used to write raps that had the swear words, see how it sounded, and then he find out he's not all about that, but now he comes out and says, look, I used to do that. I'm sure he's got something someplace in the vault with him cussing on it, but he took a stand and said, if I'm going to do this the right way, if I'm going to do this the way that I feel like I'm guided to do it, then I am not going to compromise in terms of my language. To each their own. But you know what? This dude comes harder than almost anybody I've ever heard in my life and never cusses. You figure it out. Try to rap without cussing. It's very difficult.
He does it, did it for a while, wasn't into all the custom. Tried to find who I was, being everything I was in real life. Yeah, got a lot of anger, you know where I'm at. Put it all over the pages and wrote it in the rap. Said that we could be amazing if I give us a chance. Now I'm looking around like, yeah, look at where we at. Look at where we at now, we ain't made it yet. But they can hear us in the background coming. Some are gonna hate it, some are gonna love it. I'ma put it in his hands and let God do the judging. Yeah, remember me and you, always had you in the backpack. Took you into school, writing on you like it's nothing. A lot of people in the room see me scribble on the page, but they ain't got a clue. No, they ain't got a clue. We at the beginning, hoping someday you and I can say we made it and we did it. You ain't nothing but a notepad. Tell me who you kidding. I'ma
just running out of space. I'll be begging a minute, turn the page, homie. Ooh, turn the page, homie. I'll tell you what. I've had quite a bit of people, you know, come in and rap here at the studio, and I'll be honest with you, the ones that are here and ready to go are the ones that are prepared. The ones that are prepared have two things in common. One, they come with a just an ambition of hunger. They're not stuttering and stumbling. They have already practiced. They want to record. They want this to sound well. Another thing in common is they've always got a notebook with them. Or nowadays, they still have the, you know, they have the phone with the notes on it. Because everything they do is part of this. It's like, it's almost like a free compilation of just poetry, short stories, thoughts, hooks, bar, anything you've got is all in this book. Very important to somebody who does this stuff. But a notepad, tell me, who you kidding? I'm just running out of space.
I'll be begging a minute, turn the page on me. You know what's crazy is, this just started as something that was an escape for us, you know? And now I look around and there's a lot of people out there going through the same things, you know, we've been through. Now this music we write is actually making an impact. It's crazy.
That's the goal. Fire. That was fire. Absolute fire again. And this is an early Nate. This isn't even the mature Nate that we've all run into as of late. This is the guy that started off with a calling and really was trying to just hone his craft and polish his craft. And he's still on the potter's wheel, right? Still. So he could be shaped and molded by who he's called to, you know, present this information to. And he said, look, this is starting to have impact because the platform has raised. The amount of people and the amount of ears that are being tuned in was completely different. Now when he drops music, people are like, they're just dying for a new song, kind of like I am right now. May 7th, can you get here soon enough? Because we think that there's either a song or an album called Lost coming out on May 7th. Still a couple months, but hey, patiently waiting. You know what? Two thumbs up. Thank you for the recommendation. Shout out to the, you know, the Notepad crew that said, hey, we got to do this. I'd say this. If you like the content, please consider subscribing. Hit the notification bell so you can be notified when we drop new content. Please like the video and please just throw a comment down. Good job, dude. NF is dope. Any of that stuff to help with YouTube's stupid algorithm on how it gets it out to the masses. So that being said, until we get back on the NF train again, we're out of here. Thanks for your time.